Those who want to make a quick buck out of other people's grief don't take vacations. Avoid getting victimized by the high cost of dying. So today's show, we will unravel the clever maneuvers of the funeral industry and give you tools to protect yourself. I'm Edric Mendoza and this is On The Money. Our guest today is Christian Dychangco, director of Serviam Funeral Planners, Inc. Christian comes from a family that has been in the funeral business for almost 100 years. Hi, Christian.
Hi, Andrew.
Or Ian, is that what you prefer being called?
You can call me Ian.
Sure. Ian, you know, I hear that it can become very expensive these days to die or have a service around it. Apparently, Michael Jackson, for example, his casket was exorbitantly priced. You want to tell us a little bit about that?
Well, Michael Jackson's casket is a Promethean casket.
Which effectively means?
It's a U.S. casket, U.S. made casket. Mm-hmm. It's mechanically, it's chemically treated on the inside.
Chemically treated, to do
To avoid rust and corrosion.
Okay.
So, it's a 48-ounce solid brushed copper.
Wow. So it costs in the range of, what is the price for something like that?
Here in the Philippines, they charge that from 2 to actually until 6 million pesos.
6 million peso casket. It's like the Rolls Royce of caskets.
Yeah, exactly.
Or like the Ferrari. Yeah. Wow. Whereas typically, how much does a casket really cost?
Well,
just for benchmark.
Well,
it's like
that. Roughly around 150,000 to 300,000.
For all of that.
All of that.
Okay. 150 to 300.
150 inclusive of the casket, okay. The lightings, and if you want floral arrangements,
Okay, and you're saying that a person who is in a situation like that ideally should have a menu of options so they know which ones to choose, right? But, you know, I think we were saying earlier and we were talking about how the reality is not many people actually do that. And in fact, many people in this business, if you will, take advantage of the fact that people are grieving. You want to expound on that, Ian?
Because you know what happens when the family is grieving. Of course, you're derailed, you can't think straight. Mm-hmm. You know, you're in that process wherein you just want
to... You're still in shock, right?
Yeah, you're shocked, you're in denial of what happened. Mm-hmm. So what typical funeral parlors do is that they assess the family.
Expound on that.
Yeah, so when let's say a family visits a funeral parlor, they look at on how affluent the family looks like.
Really?
So, if you tend to...
They're measuring them, they're sizing them up, okay.
Yeah, well, they look at on how you dress. Mm-hmm. So, if you're wearing a Rolex, then maybe...
Must be kaya to.
Yes,
okay.
The price of the casket is much higher.
Then it really is.
Then I see.
Okay.
That's the reality of it.
Right, right. So...
As compared to if you customize a funeral, then... The funeral parlor can't overcharge because you're given a fixed price, a fixed cost for this particular casket, for this particular lights. And so it's very flexible. It's very transparent.
Right. So what you're saying is, typically, funeral parlors will size you up.
Yeah.
And after they size you up, they will just slap a lump sum amount.
Yeah. What
else should they be looking at or how can they be careful? So when they see the package... what should they know coming into that discussion?
Well, first of all, I think before getting into this funeral parlor, I think you should first decide on whether to get a traditional funeral package, wherein prices are, you know, different and it's really not flexible as compared to a funeral in funeral planning, wherein it's like a wedding. I mean. In weddings, you customize your music, your gown, and
interesting, and
the theme. In funeral planning, we also do the same.
Right.
So let's say the deceased is a golfer.
Yeah.
We can make a theme out of the viewing area wherein his golf clubs are displayed to make it more not to make it happy a happier setup.
Right. That's great news. That is great news. So tell me about, in the typical package, all told, what is the most expensive item? Is it the casket?
Yeah, usually it's the casket.
Okay.
It depends on the kind of the casket.
Understood. So tell us a little bit more about the casket. What is a range of a good casket now if someone was to go for a funeral planning as opposed to just a lump sum?
Well, a 20-gauge steel casket is good enough. It's a 20-gauge protective casket wherein the casket has this rubber gasket around the...
the edges.
Yeah.
So, and that's supposed to... What does that do for the body, for
so
example?
So it preserves the body longer.
I see. And that is the goal of the casket.
Yes.
So what would that cost?
That will cost around 80,000 pesos to 100.
Okay.
Including the lights,
right,
if you add the lights. But if you want the casket only in planning, you can get that casket for only 80,000.
What is a traditional package range nowadays? I mean, depending on how they size you up, but what would be a...
The range would be around 350,000.
For all the package. Is this the same for people who opt for like cremation, for example, or is cremation a different set of expenses altogether from just a standard?
It actually depends on the family if they want the viewing first before they cremate, or if they want straight cremation.
Right.
So it really varies.
Okay.
So they have different packages for different requests.
I see. Yeah. Okay. And let's say viewing before cremation. Or let's opt for the no viewing.
No
it's just
viewing,
cremation.
Yeah.
Is that going to be as expensive as having a traditional casket, etc.?
No, it's actually going to be cheaper if you're going to opt for
straight cremation.
Yeah.
It is
because
cheaper.
Because you'll just have to pay for the first call services.
First
call services is the when you pick up the body from the hospital to the morgue, and then
they go to the cremation process.
Yeah, through the cremation process, and then. Yeah. So an urn is definitely cheaper than
a casket. So about $350 if it's traditional.
Yeah.
If it's cremation, what is the total package cost? Your estimate?
Maybe around $100,000.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So tell me, I understand in this market, if you will, caskets. There's even China caskets.
Yeah. There's China
right?
caskets.
You want to talk a little bit about that?
Well, China and U.S. caskets are similar because actually the China caskets they copied it from the U.S. caskets.
That happens. Okay.
Yeah, so
very interesting.
Just like
even
cars.
In this niche. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, huh? Merong copy.
Yeah.
Wow. All right. And then so a China casket, so that people will know, hey, this is a little bit too cheap. What is the range of something like that?
Well, China caskets ranges from 60,000 to 200,000 pesos.
Okay.
Yeah, it depends on how thick the steel.
Right. Is it true that some of the data that I have says that it can actually cost anywhere from 3 to 10,000? Merabang ganon? Not cheap.
Those are local caskets.
Local,
locally made caskets.
I see, and those will not last very long. I can imagine, right? All right, but if for families that are really trying to scrimp and save,
So
a planner could help you.
Yeah, a planner can
choose
help
something
you.
Like that. Okay, what other ways do traditional planners sort of tuck in fees that will catch you off guard and that will take advantage? Like,
one is the embalming.
Embalming.
Yeah.
How so?
After embalming, sometimes before they start the embalming process, they will ask the family, how days will the wake be?
How many days?
How many days? Yeah. So the family will answer, for example, 5 days. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, the family will go to the funeral director and tell the funeral director, wait, we have relatives from the States coming over.
Can we go longer?
So we need to go longer. Mm-hmm. And then this funeral director from this traditional funeral parlor will tell the family that we'll be extending for 2 days because we only embalmed for 5 days.
Ah.
So for that additional 2 days, they will charge you again for the injection.
To help the body
to preserve it more longer.
Right.
But that's nonsense because once you embalm, that embalmed cadaver is good for the next 20 to 50 years.
Really?
So
wow, good to know.
So what's the use of adding formalin or adding chemicals?
Right.
It's just going to spoil the body even more.
How would you recommend a person or a family to, knowing this information, what can they do proactively to prevent themselves from, you know, being charged more than they should be actually paying
for?
General advice.
I think you should, you know, be positive about it.
Okay.
Because death is an inevitable event. So, I mean, you can't run away with it. You can't run away from it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, you definitely would need to face it.
Right.
So, it's gonna be more practical if you plan it. Just right. Like weddings, yeah. You wouldn't want to be, you know, attending a wedding na andun ka na bigla.
Of course, exactly. So you want it to be prepared.
Yeah, you prepare for it. Yeah. You know, you fix the budget of the family.
Right.
Before choosing a casket, mm-hmm. You know, set aside, you know, maybe an amount.
Okay.
Wherein, oh, this is my budget for the casket. Yeah. I'll be spending, let's say, 100,000, mm-hmm. and then for the lights,
I
for the catering.
Amount.
Yeah.
I see.
And then in that way, you'll be, you know, yeah. You wouldn't be charged that much.
Sure. We'll have more questions for you in a bit, Ian. We just have to pause for a short break right now, so keep it here. On the Money, we'll be right back. Welcome back to On The Money. Time now for a daily dose of Salve Says with Salve Duplito.
Just about everyone on the planet likes getting gifts, especially those that are expensive or that show you've placed a lot of thought on the person receiving the gift. But are there times when a gift should have you saying, thanks but no thanks?
Let's say you were given a weekend stay at the very exclusive Balesin Island in Quezon, where the rich and famous enjoy white sand beaches, coves, and lush forests. You need to fly to get to the island, and the weekend stay costs 300,000 pesos. But here's the deal. The gift comes from a total stranger. Would you take it?
There are no hard and fast rules on gift giving, even more so on receiving gifts. And since we're on the subject of wealth, what's so wrong about gifts that can make you richer and happier?
Oo, pag binigyan ako ng perang kapamilya ko, tatanggapin ko. Understood naman na yun, syempre kapamilya mo nga siya. Alangan mag-ask pa siya in return.
Sa tanongin kung ano, kung saan niya gusto kong gamitin yon. Let's say, bili mo na ang mga kailangan mo, especially in my daily needs. Sabi nga nila, give and take, di ba? Pag meron ka, magbigay ka. Pag meron sila, humingi ka. Ang pinapoint on mo dun is magtulungan kayo. Kaya ka binibigyan siguro ng ganun. Siyempre, nakikita niya, sobra-sobra yung pera niya.
A friend of mine just told me the other day, her sister gave her niece a 1 million cash gift for the young girl's 8th birthday. But she said, gifts like these normally come with a price. Hence the decision to return the gift with a happy thanks but no thanks.
Beware of free money and gifts with unseen ties. They can break up relationships and cause unhappiness. So when you're blinded by the amount, always remember, true wealth is so much more than cash in the bank.
Still with us is Christian Dychangco, Director of Serviam Funeral Planners Incorporated. He will answer some of the questions you sent us via email, Twitter, and Facebook. Mel, what questions do we have for Ian today?
Ian, the first question comes from Eileen, who says, a friend has been asking me to buy a memorial plan for him. I'm skeptical because of all the pre-need companies that have closed shop. Is it really advisable to get one? Baka mauna pang mamatay ang pre-need company kesa gagamit ng memorial plan.
That's a good point. Huh? Yeah, that's a good point. Oh, your thoughts?
Yeah, actually, personally, I don't advise people to get, you know, memorial plans.
Why?
Because, yeah, first of all, yun na nga, yung concern niya na baka mauna pang mamatay ang
pre-need
company compared dun sa gagamit.
For that first.
Mm-hmm. That's true, eh. What if nga, mauna, o nasa na yung money, who will you run after, di ba?
Sure.
So, I think it's more practical to, you know, go to a funeral planner instead. And, you know, plan your funeral ahead,
yeah.
But don't pay for anything first because you're not going to use it anytime soon anyway.
Exactly.
Set it aside, right?
Yeah, and, mm-hmm. you know, in memorial plans, mm-hmm. let's say you pay $150,000 for a plan, mm-hmm. 10, 15 years from now, would you still remember the looks
specifics,
of the
yeah.
specific casket that mm-hmm. the plan
right.
showed you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And in the end, you'll end up paying even more.
Because
yeah.
you've forgotten
yeah, because
already,
you have forgotten
yeah,
everything.
That's a good point.
Exactly.
And I'm sure the memorial plan will ask you to upgrade your plan. Hmm. Because that's
right.
pangit casket.
Yeah,
eh.
The one that you actually ended
yeah,
up
so
with. No?
Yeah, they just want you to get in the door.
Yeah,
they want
in the end,
get,
you'll
yeah.
pay double.
Yeah.
As compared, if you go to a funeral planner, mm-hmm. you plan it first, and then when the time comes, you go back, you get your plan, mm-hmm. you review it. If mm-hmm. you want to add or remove mm-hmm. services, you can do that.
So Jenny is asking, my mom is turning 80 next year and she's frail already. I tried bringing up funeral preparations for her when she dies, but my siblings brushed me off and said that I'm insensitive. On my part, I'm merely being practical. How can I have my siblings understand this? What costs should we be prepared for?
Well, it's a matter of conversing with the person, eh, with the sister, eh.
Mm-hmm.
It's a matter of explaining to her that it's gonna be more practical, you
of
know,
course.
To prepare for it. Diba, would you want to be yun nga,
caught
take,
off guard? Yeah,
yeah.
Caught
off guard mm-hmm. na
and they're
when
in
you
denial.
Need it, biglang
well,
ayan
na,
oh, this is 150,000.
Yeah.
Take it or leave
yeah.
it. Diba?
It's gonna get you one day. You're gonna
right.
die.
So you might as well bite the bullet yeah. and just talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's gonna be practical mm-hmm. to, I mean, keep. An amount like, for example, 200,000 to 300,000, and then from there you can, you know, add services and remove services and make the 300,000
work
fit.
For you.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
yeah. So she could actually arrange this all for 300,000.
Yeah,
and that's what she could tell her siblings. These are the costs.
Yeah,
that
these
we
are
need
the
to
costs.
Prepare.
We have to prepare for this, mm-hmm. and you know, it's not, you don't have to be. You don't have to pay for. Millions mm-hmm. to get a nice, you know, tribute.
A Michael Jackson
yeah.
casket
yeah.
like that.
Yeah. So they would have to decide: do we want to bury our mother in a casket? Do we
or
want, or do
want
we want to have her cremated?
If you want it cheaper, then maybe you can opt to, you know, just after dying,
mm-hmm.
go straight to cremation and mm-hmm. then just get an urn.
So actually, that's perfect. Gary asks that cremation question. He says, is cremation cheaper compared to traditional burial?
Yeah, it actually depends. If you're gonna hold a viewing
before mm-hmm.
before cremating, it's gonna be more pricey because mm-hmm. you'll have to pay for two permits.
Exactly.
For the cremation permit.
How much is
for
a permit?
Well, it depends. It ranges from 5,000 to 10,000.
Okay, so you'd pay for two, cremation
yeah.
and
cremation and
traditional
burial.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, if you opt to just cremate it, then it's going to be definitely cheaper.
How much is cremation, out of curiosity?
30,000.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's
cheap.
A
lot
yeah.
cheaper. Yeah,
that's
and you were saying the whole ceremony for cremation would be about 100, right? That's what you're saying, everything.
Yeah. So cremation is cheaper, and then it depending on whether you just decide to go straight to cremation or have a
or
viewing.
Have a viewing. Mm-hmm.
What are the other additional costs for cremation, like the urns, and if you choose to store the urn someplace? What are your choices as far as cremation goes afterwards?
After cremation, you can opt to just keep the urn at home
mm-hmm.
and build an altar or something. Mm-hmm. In fact, there are urns nowadays wherein it's a sundial urn. It's really placed in gardens.
Right.
And then, yeah, it's really an outdoor
cool.
urn. We call it an outdoor urn.
Right.
Nice.
Because you can just place it at home.
Right.
Okay.
So,
And then what if you want to, like, what if there are lots of siblings mm-hmm. and you want to split up the ashes? I mean, what do you do?
You can get an urn wherein it comes with a keepsake. Mm-hmm. That keepsake, you can divide the ashes amongst the siblings mm-hmm. so that each one has.
So you put the ashes in that keepsake.
Yeah, in the keepsake, and then you can put it in a bracelet, a pendant, or a keychain if you want.
Right.
That's great.
I had a question on the crypt cost. You know how, let's say, a traditional burial, you pay for a plot of land, but for a crypt,
It actually depends. Parang condo yan eh.
Okay, really?
It actually depends on the
interesting. The location.
The lower the location, it's more expensive.
See, like realist. Okay.
Wow.
As compared
so
to the ones on top.
Yeah. Approximately how much for the lower ones?
For the lower ones. Another thing, it depends on the location.
Yeah.
Siguro roughly around 50 to 80,000.
Low, okay. That would be a good price for a crypt.
Yeah. Okay. For
crypts. That's for life. You can just park it there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
And then, the ones on top.
Will be higher, of course.
Yeah.
And you own the space or it's just leased long term? What is it? What is
you have a title for that.
Yeah. Really?
Oh, wow.
A TCT for a space or a CCT, right? Yeah. Maybe condominium title.
Yeah, I guess you can block off a bunch of spaces for you and your family, can you?
Very interesting.
You can.
That's great.
They do pre-selling.
Yeah. Pre-selling as well. Really like real estate now, huh, Mel?
Yeah, I know.
Okay, very interesting.
What's the price range of urns before we...
Well, wooden urns ranges from around 15,000 to 30,000. And then we have that urns made out of pewter.
Okay.
And it's roughly around 30 to 50,000.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Right.
Okay. Great.
Wonderful.
Thank you, Ian. Send us your money questions via email, Facebook, or Twitter, and we'll try to answer them in our upcoming episodes or on our next Q&A Friday.
Right, so death is inevitable. I like that. It's good to plan ahead.
Yeah.
And now with the advent of financial planning, you can not be caught off guard. You can pick and choose. Great discussions. Thank you, Ian, Mel. Wonderful discussions again. That's our show today. I'm Edric Mendoza. Join us again tomorrow for more talking tips so you're always right on the money.